Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today I'm going to teach you how to do this seashore painting, okay? And in this painting I'll show you how to create the patterns of the rocks out here, which you can see, and how to get this realistic effect of the sea, how to create a realistic look of the waves and the sea, like how the sea is hitting the rocks, this effect. I'll show you the entire effect of, and I'll teach you how to create these layers of rocks, okay? Like you can see both the paintings. So actually a very sad thing happened today. Actually I lost all the footage, the entire footage of this painting. That's why I had to make another painting, the same painting over again, and this time I created a smaller version to save time. And the tutorial which you are going to see will be of this small painting, okay? So it took me a lot of effort to create both the paintings. So if you please stay till the end, okay? Because I will be explaining everything in details, and this is actually very easy to make, okay? Like everyone can paint it. So let's get to the tutorial.
So first of all, we are using flesh tint, okay? So we want various colors for the rocks, and we want some layers in those colors, okay? So why is that? That's how we are going to get the difference of layers in the rocks, and that's how we are going to define, okay? So here I use some light brown, and now I'm using yellow ochre. So after that I'm using some white out here. The only reason is that I wanted a lighter version of the rocks out there, okay? There I'm using some black, and I'll be using some grays as well, okay? Little bit got left out there, but I use some gray also over the light brown and yellow ochre area, okay? This portion will be black, and always maintain this, like whatever color you put, always blend it before applying another layer, okay? Now I'm using brown. I'm using heating technique with every step, okay? So in case you don't know what the heating technique is, I'll give the link in the I button. Just press there and you'll get a video of heating technique, okay? So here I am making the patterns, okay? So like I said in the beginning, that the entire footage of the original painting got lost. So here I'm showing you the technique. The painting which I did at first was a little bit bigger, okay? So when you get a bigger area, you get the freedom of detailing a lot. You can use the, for even for the minute areas, you can use the white glass marking pencil as well for the detailing. But since this is a small area and I needed small strokes, that's why I'm using my toothpick out here. But if the painting is little bit big, if you're painting a bigger painting, then you can always use white glass marking pencil, because it gives a blending effect. For the sharp edges, you can use the toothpick or the empty pen, like I'm using right here, okay? So the pen which I'm using right here is actually empty. I'm just using its ball. It's a gel pen, so I'm using its tip for making the patterns. And the color which you see right now is the ochre yellow which we put earlier. I'm just taking off the layer from the top. So the top section is done, and now I'm moving on to the middle section where I put brown. Here also the technique is same. All you have to do is give small horizontal strokes. Okay, just observe carefully. So I'm giving small horizontal strokes. But mind it, only the horizontal strokes are not enough to create an impression of layers of rocks. Rock is a bit, tricky. I had to think for a night to, come out with a technique. Here I'm using dark brown. Come out with a technique that would be easy to follow. So now I'm using black. And see how I'm using the black. Like it's a pattern, like a, it's like a zigzag pattern kind of a thing. That's how. And the idea is, like, when you take away one layer, what you will be able to see is the yellow ochre. Just over it will be the brown and the dark brown and then the black. So even in this small space, you have to maintain this and some dots to create the impression that those are very fine portions of the rocks. And now some more detailing. Observation is very important for this painting, okay? Just see how I'm creating the detailing. And those can actually, these blacks can act as the shadows as well, okay? Like the dark sections of the rocks. Here I'm using some orange. And now I'm using my white glass marking pencil to do the detailing again. Here the white glass marking pencil will play a very important role. Okay. See how I took out some of the black layers as well. Here I'm using grays again. This is very important for creating the layers. So now I'm using dark brown again, just for the layering sake, okay? Just for the, for implying that there are various levels of layers. You have to give lot of, effort for the detailing. You have to spend time on it. Just observe this section in details, like how I'm focusing on the detailing. Okay, you have to pay the same amount of dedication towards the detailing, otherwise the layering won't come out. And always remember, the zigzag pattern is very important. Here I'm using sap green. It's a area near the seeds, so there will be some kind of some kind of plantations or something like that. So just to imply that, I use some sap green. When I show you the bigger painting at the end, you will notice that those detailing of the rocks looks much better. Because when you go for a bigger painting, you have better freedom of creating the detailing. See, here I am going for the black section again. I did another layer of detailing again. So you have to keep on you know, adding the detailing and some and taking it away until and unless you get that effect of layers, like the rocks are broken from some of the places, one rock is over another, or the effect, or the, you know, the is close to realistic rocks. So I use brown again, some dark brown again, and again the white glass marking pencil. I went over it quite a number of times. Okay, so here I'm using white again. Okay, so basically I covered the entire space where I have to paint the sea area. I painted it white at first. Okay, I gave a layer of white at first, and then I applied the other layers of blue. Why? Because if at any place, if I needed to press hard and get out some of the, take out some of the white from the bottom, then this would help me. So here I use some Prussian blue. Now I'm using some dark green. You know, the sea is not always completely blue. There are always some, you know, aqua green kind of effect. Now to just darken it, I use some black. Okay, and over that you can go for another layer of blue to give it a darkish blue effect. I'm using the Prussian blue. Okay, after that I'll use the sky blue to cover the entire area. See, here I'm using the sky blue. Since the bottom is already white, it will mix very nicely and is very good for layering. Just some blending with hands will be enough. But I would say there is one freedom while painting this, you know, this painting actually. Even if they do not mix, even if you are not able to mix them very nicely or with 100% accuracy, it won't be of any big issue, because you know, most of the area will get covered with white, so those areas won't show up. And if you have messed up in one area, you can always cover that with white for this painting. So here I'm using some light green. And now another layer of sky blue over it. Just I'm adding another layer of white to, you know, just dilute the color, you know, just to give it a more natural look. Heating technique, it will blend in perfectly because the colors are already soft and they don't create much problem. I'm using the Prussian blue out here again. Now some black. So you have to use this kind of a, in a combinational way. Okay, like some black, then some blue over it, then blend it a little, give it a dark effect, like there is some rocks underneath or something like that. You have to bring in that feel. Go for the feel. You'll always have to be sure if you want to go for the exact realistic look, or you wanna go for the realistic feel. With realistic feel, the strokes will be somewhat something that will bring out the feeling of realism. Like for like suppose a realistic painting might have thousands of like 3 to 4 different kind of strokes to imply that this is a realistic image. So if that is the case, then you'll have to give those strokes accurately to bring out the realism. But suppose if you are going for the realistic look, then there might be just one or two strokes that can, you know, give a generalized realistic effect that will represent a realistic look with just those one or two strokes. In this painting here, we are going for that. So now, how I created those the white portions of the sea, like if the water is breaking out there and the waves are breaking out there, that effect. So it's actually extremely easy. All you have to do is heat the white and then press hard on the paper and just move your finger, just move it in a casual way, okay? Like if it will, like, you know, just allow it to leave its traces, and automatically it will give the effect of those, of that water, and it will automatically give a realistic look. I'm just adding another rock out there, nothing more. And everywhere I'm doing the same thing, like some places are a bit whiter because I pressed harder out there, and then I just varied the pressure to leave it a trail of white, and that's how I got the realistic look, nothing else. It might look very tough, but it's actually damn easy. Like anybody can do it, okay? Anybody can do it. There's nothing special in it. All you have to do is heat the white a little bit more, allow it to cool a little, and then just press hard on the paper and allow it to leave its trail. So we are almost done out here, and this will continue. I hope you liked it, and if you like the video, then please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and comment in the section below if you have any questions, okay? And don't forget to press the bell notification, because I give new video every week, and this took me a lot of effort to create it, because the previous video got deleted completely. I lost the entire footage. So if you stuck till the end, then thanks a ton. And I'll meet you in the next video. So until next time, goodbye.